For the Auburn Tigers, a repeat performance of last year's upset victory over the Bulldogs would suit them just fine. An all-out aerial assault punished the Dogs between the hedges. But friendly confines of home have not been as kind as of late in this neighborly rivalry. The men of red and black have turned to the defense all season long. Georgia's looking for payback on the Plains, and Donnan will set the Dogs loose. Georgia's salivating to play the spoiler, a must-win for the Tigers to keep pace in the SEC West. Take the field before a capacity house here at Jordan-Hare Stadium. A very special night. It's the final home game of the 2000 season for Auburn. And the other reason it's a very special night, when you look at the standings as the Bulldogs come calling on the Auburn Tigers, number 13 against number 23. Look at the SEC West. Auburn, LSU, Mississippi State, all tied with 4-2 records. And even before this game is over tonight, LSU and Ole Miss will start their game, which has super importance for the SEC West. The star is missing tonight. Quincy Carter, that right thumb in a cast, he will not be able to go tonight. And that means enter a young man by the name of Corey Phillips. And in fact, look at this. Corey Phillips and Ben Laird, they went to the same high school, Hartwell, Georgia. Hi, once again, everybody. Ron Franklin, along with my regular partner, Mike Godfrey. And Mike, let's talk about the quarterback situation, because it's huge tonight. How much of a different football team is Georgia with Corey rather than Quincy?
Ron, there's a lot of people, including the Auburn coaches, that think Georgia's a more dangerous team with Corey Phillips playing the quarterback position, because they believe they'll run the ball a little bit more and a little bit more play-action pass. Don't be surprised, Terrence Edwards, a wide receiver who is a high school quarterback, will play some quarterback tonight. He played it in the pregame warm-up.
You told me yesterday in our production meeting you think this is the kind of game that Ben Laird, he either wins or helps lose for Auburn.
Well, Gary Gibbs, the defensive coordinator for Georgia, plays heavy zone 98% of the time. So Ben Laird's going to have a lot of windows to throw tonight.
The two head coaches in this ball game, Jim Donnan, fifth season as the Georgia head coach, almost 70% his winning percentage. And Tommy Tuberville, in his second year as the Auburn head coach, he is 12-8. Auburn won the toss. They have deferred. Georgia will receive. So Damon Duvall will kick it off. And Bruce Thornton and Milliken are the two deep men. As you look in the eyes of Duvall, the 104th meeting between Auburn and Georgia, and it is underway. Very high, very long, out of the back of the end zone. Down to the sideline, and Adrian Karsten.
Ron, you need to know that even though Quincy Carter is not going to play in this game, he still will play a very significant role, because over the last 24 hours, his primary self-responsibility has been to get close to Corey Phillips and just calm him down. Last night, in a one-on-one interview under the hot television lights, he really had that deer in the headlights look to him. Corey's face was white. His hands were shaking. Now, how he plays in front of 85,000-86,000 may be a totally different deal, but if he needs some support physically, psychologically, Quincy Carter becomes his assistant coach tonight, Ron.
Well, we will watch it very, very closely, because this crowd is up and cheering and very noisy, and they will go straight ahead with a run in the first play. Jasper Sanks is knocked down after a gain of a couple. So here are the starting lineups. The young man we're talking about, 6'1", 212 out of Hartwell, Georgia. And the people that he will have with him, Milliken and Sanks, the running backs, Terrence Edwards, who also, as Mike said, will play some quarterback, and LeBron Mitchell, the wide receivers. Javaris Johnson, one of three tight ends we'll see for Georgia this evening. Musa Smith, who had his knee scoped 2 weeks ago, number 32, is lined up at tailback. They fake it to him, and the pass comes out to Edwards, and oh, he gets struck by Rodney Creighton. Driven back, and this crowd really aroused by that hit. The offensive line for the Georgia Bulldogs, if the name looks familiar, should be Stenchcomb, younger brother of Jonas Jennings on the other side. Very good one and a veteran. And Mike, talk about the people they face off against.
Yeah, the best defensive lineman for Auburn is DeMarco McNeil, number 92, redshirt freshman out of Pritchard, Alabama. He'll be active against this Georgia offensive line.
Good look at him. 6'1", 296 pounds. Short walk to the line of scrimmage, but that play clock is down to five. Gonna have to hurry. Down to three, down to two, they snap it. And Phillips' throw got it complete. Again, it's Edwards, and he'll be stopped short of the first down. Rashad Walker, number 37, is there to make the tackle, and a standing ovation for this Auburn defense.
Ron, not a bad start for Corey Phillips. Two little short passes just to get him untracked a little bit. That's the design.
Jonathan Kilgo, a sophomore out of Silver Creek, Georgia, stands back to punt. You see his numbers. His long is 66, inside the 20-13, and an average of almost 42 per try. Clifton Robinson is the deep man. Good hanging spiral, good cover kick. Robinson for the 34, gets by one, will not get by number two. And the tackle is made instantly on the special teams by Ryan Fleming. 41 yards in the kick and a minus one on the return. So the starters for Auburn. Young man is now a senior. Also, as we said, from Hartwell, Georgia. Has gone through a lot of adversity, but has handled it tremendously well. The people he will have with him: Rudy Johnson and Heath Evans behind him. Daniels and Reggie Worthy, the wide receivers. Lorenzo Diamond, the tight end. They, too, will feature three different tight ends at times tonight. We'll get Mike to talk about it. They will open up in four wide receivers. And, in fact, they have done it right now. From the shotgun. Gets it out. Clifton Robinson close to the 40-yard line. Tripped up at the 39. The offensive line starts like this. Simmons, McGarry, Nowlin, probably the most pleasant surprise of that group. And talk about, ooh, the folks that he faced off against.
Ron, if Georgia wins tonight, they win because of this defensive line. Now, they're all very good players. Josh Millard is my candidate tonight to be the guy that puts pressure on Ben Laird.
So Rudy stays in the backfield, Rudy Johnson. Heath Evans goes to the sidelines. And again, it is a four wide receiver set. Rudy Johnson takes it straight ahead. It'll be good for the first down at the 44. Witherspoon there to make the tackle for the Georgia Bulldogs. Georgia's linebackers, the guy you got to look at. Witherspoon had just made a stop. Bell has improved tremendously, and this happens a lot of times with junior college players. All of a sudden, that window gets a lot bigger the second year. Henderson and Wansley, the corners. Jermaine Phillips and Vieira are the safeties. Mike, talk about the philosophy of what Auburn is doing. A little bit of a hurry up, going with the four wideouts.
They're trying to, their plan tonight obviously is going to involve tiring Richard Seymour and Marcus Stroud.
Make them chase, tackles. Huh?
Make them chase, go on a long count, go on a quick count, cut them.
Robert Johnson comes in, a good block on Grant. Johnson turns the corner, has a blocker in front. That's Pusillo, and he is going to take it out. Almost for another first down as Vieira comes up from the secondary. You could see big number 79 and McGarry also out front blocking. But boy, the crash block inside, Robert Johnson really took out Charles Grant.
Yeah, and again, Rudy Johnson's the kind of back that'll wear you down into the fourth quarter. And they're starting this ball game everything wide. The quick pass on the outside, then the counter play wide. Again, trying to make these defensive linemen of Georgia run.
Two tight ends this time, two wide receivers, and a single back. Rudy Johnson again. Laird gives it to Johnson. Good hit right in the middle. Breaks off that tackle, though. Marcus Stroud is the man who hit him first. But I believe on the second effort that he is going to have the first down. Very close to the 45-yard line of Georgia.
And Marcus Stroud and Richard Seymour are two big defensive linemen. You're going to see Stroud right here set up Ben Nowlin in the center and make the play on Rudy Johnson. And he needs some help because he can't get his arms off of Nowlin.
Nowlin did push him back just far enough that second effort, they're going to bring the chains in. But from where they have spotted it, it is very close to the 45 and maybe half the length of the football, but it would appear that they do have it. Wrong again, Franklin. Miss it by an inch.
You didn't get a good night's sleep last night. Marcus Stroud and Richard Seymour give Georgia's defense a chance up inside. They're so strong at holding the point at the line of scrimmage.
Second So just inches, just a couple of inches is all they need on this third down. Again, two tight ends, Diamond and Robert Johnson. And Laird straight ahead with the quarterback sneak. But I don't know. Marcus Stroud pushes him back. Now they have now stepped in and put the foot down squarely on the 45-yard line. Also, Seymour was there to help out.
When we came to do the LSU game, and in the first three ball games, Ben Laird quarterback sneak for 7 first downs. So they're back at it tonight again. 6'4", 222 pounds. Pretty good size quarterback to get that half yard.
You know what's interesting about him, though, in a stat that we got yesterday, Mike? He has picked up first downs with a quarterback sneak, but not one time this year has he come out of the pocket and run for a first down on a scramble.
Not a scrambler.
Swings the pass. Get this to Carter. Carter, the little guy that when we were here against LSU, they kicked off to him at the goal line, and 100 yards later, he said, see
you. Talking to Noel Mazzoni about Tim Carter, he said that he has a chance to be as good as anyone in the country next year. He's disciplined now. He's got toughness. He's a track athlete. Hurt a lot last year. You could see the good block by Reggie Worthy. It's a nice drive by Auburn. They script their plays. They went through this drive yesterday in practice at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. The players know it. They walked through it last night. A lot of confidence.
About to go under 9 minutes to play in his opening quarter. Diamond in motion, but they give it to Rudy Johnson. Breaks one tackle. Will not break the second one. That's Millard. Rudy Johnson. 4 carries, 19 yards, and has 10 yards after contact. We'll elaborate on that as the evening goes on. They pull the guard and nothing doing. Caught from the backside. That's Hollingshead, who does a nice job of coming in to make the tackle. Junior out of Fort Valley, Georgia.
Bringing Heath Evans into the football game, Ron. More of a pass receiver, fullback, lead blocker for Rudy Johnson.
He's a junior out of West Palm Beach. Saw Heath and his parents yesterday at lunch. Very proud folks up here for this final home game of his junior year.
Like to put him on linebackers.
Laird has the time. Intercepted. That is Biera, and he's going to take it the distance. 74 yards.
Richard Seymour was there putting pressure, but Ben Laird, I watched him after the play, and he was beating the ground with his right hand. He knows he made a big mistake in throwing this football. See if we get any pressure on him. No, he just gets bumped a little bit, but you see the throw. He's not even near the wide receiver, and he got away from him.
Simmons was being pushed back into it.
This is what Georgia needs because they got a young quarterback, and you'd like to have a good start with a young quarterback.
Extra point attempt is up, and it is good by Billy Bennett. And just this quickly, a drive that Auburn had made look very, very good up until this play. Laird beats the ground, and it's Georgia on top by 7.
You all right?
I can never find what I need in here.
I have 4 words for you. Craftsman Universal Tool Set. This 56-piece set will stop you from wasting time looking for the right tool. Check out the Universal Tooth Design. It fits 6 different types of fasteners. It can fit a hex, 12-point, square, external torx, spline, partially rounded hex. This wrench can tackle nearly anything. And the high-contrast black lettering helps you find the right size right away.
Plus, it's ideal for precise control in tight spaces.
And the 56-piece universal tool set comes with a lifetime guarantee. Hurry into Sears, visit us online at craftsman.com/universal or call 1-888-353-8564 to get a great deal. And for a limited time only, it's only $79.99. That's a savings of $20, with some smaller sets starting as low as $19.99.
Sears, home of Craftsman.
Would $1,000 in your checking account today bring you relief tomorrow? Hi, I'm Warren Moon, a proud member of the Pro Money Source team. Click or call us, and within 24 hours, we can get you up to $1,000 deposited directly into your bank account. Think of it. Rent, paid. Childcare costs, paid. Household expenses, paid. Pro Money Source connects you to hundreds of lenders. Click or call now and get cash in your bank account today.
Two elite teams battle aboard the USS Carl Vinson. Michigan State versus preseason number one North Carolina. The Quicken Loans Carrier Classic, Friday at 7 on ESPN.
My home ain't much. But with the Watch ESPN app, I could stream one game on my iPad when there's another on the tube. Shoot, all I'm missing is a sofa, a bed, toothpaste, deodorant, someone to tell me I need deodorant, a floor.
WatchESPN.com and the Watch ESPN app. The ESPN networks, live anywhere.
Unusual to have a night game up there this late in the season.
I talked to Mel Kiper and Larry Beal today. They did a radio show from there, and it was snowing in the afternoon.
You remember we did the, what the?
Iowa State.
Iowa State and K-State up there, and it snowed like the Dickens. Dangerous pass right over the middle. That thing almost intercepted. Adrian, let's check with you again. What do you have for us?
More on Big Colin Sears, the right offensive guard. He has trouble run blocking, not so much pass blocking, because besides the right ankle, he took a good crack to the inside of the right knee, Ron, where there's no pad whatsoever. So he can backpedal, protect Ben Leard if he has to, but he can't push off. Significant, because Rudy Johnson, just coming out of the game now, loves to run behind those big guys up front, especially inside the tackles.
Keith Evans is the lone setback this time, number 44. Laird drops it, picks it up, zings the pass, and almost intercepted. As the fight going on right now for possession, Jamie Henderson did take it away from him. Worthy is the man they were trying to get it to.
It all happened because the snap was too low. Ben Laird didn't have the right timing. When he finally picks up the football, tries to get it into Reggie Worthy. Ball's dropped. Now he picks it up. Now he throws. Now right here sits Henderson, 31, in great shape to pick this football off. Because of the drop snap, this caused the interception.
That was Cube Bellin, number 61, who had come in replacing Nowlin at center with the snap. And you can see the nice play made by Henderson for the interception. So the second pickoff of the night by the Georgia Bulldogs as they go straight ahead on a running play, and it sinks.
Ron, what happens when you get an early touchdown, 7-0? Jim Donnan now, and all of a sudden they get a turnover. He doesn't want to take the wraps off Corey Phillips yet because he knows his defense has got Auburn's number right now. So he doesn't want to cut loose. But if you're ever going to cut loose, this is the field position to do it in. Let him throw the ball down the field.
The most, if you're a Georgia fan, the most beautiful thing that they've done tonight, they've taken this very noisy and partisan house right out of the ballgame.
Now the crowd's trying to get this defense back in the ballgame.
Edwards in motion, second down and 7. And it's Milliken, nothing there this time. Going to be driven back. Alex Lincoln, the middle linebacker.
I want to go back again, Jim Donnan's thinking, because I know he's a little bit concerned about turning him loose because he don't want to give up the scoring opportunity. He knows he's got a chance for 3 down here. Brett Milliken on the run, but Auburn is just too tough against the run. If you're only going to run the football against Auburn, they're going to crowd that line of scrimmage with 8-9 people.
You could see on that replay that the tackle was made by Lincoln, but it was Thomas, number 54, who took the blocker down and made the whole play blow up. 3rd down and 9. Back into the short side of the field, throws it complete to McNeil. Yeah, a little woofing going on there with Walker.
But that's the thinking now. You want the opportunity not to make the mistake, not to get 3. But as this game unfolds, Corey Phillips is going to work down the field a little bit more as Jim Donnan gets a little more confidence in him.
Well, McNeil took a chance there. On our isolation, as we let McNeil threw the ball at him after he knocked him out of bounds. Lucky he didn't get a 15-yard penalty. 34-yard field goal attempt by Bennett, and he knocks it home. So put an asterisk by all 10 points. Both have come off turnovers, interceptions of Ben Laird. And that's the reason the Bulldogs are on top by a count of 10-0. Let's take a break. 11-13 left until halftime.
Hi, I'm Montel Williams from Money Mutual, your trusted source to over 60 lenders that can get you up to $1,000 in your checking account by tomorrow. These are tough times, and if you're facing an unexpected car repair bill, a medical emergency, or you just need extra cash to hold you over until payday, then you need to know about Money Mutual, an easy way to get short-term cash fast. So forget about bounced checks, overdraft charges, and late fees. Need cash tomorrow? Call 1-800-585-CASH today.
Tonight on ABC, it's time for the country to cut loose. The CMA Awards, with performances by Taylor Swift, Blake Shelton, Carrie Underwood, Jason Aldean, Scotty McCreery, Lady Antebellum, plus Brad Paisley, Vince Gill, and Keith Urban, with a special tribute to Glenn Campbell. And for the first time in 5 years, Faith Hill returns to the CMA stage. Hosted by Brad and Carrie, the CMA Awards, live tonight, 8, 7 Central on ABC.
We're on the road with the General, talking to people about their auto insurance.
Well, most of us here are living from paycheck to paycheck.
So you really need to lower the cost of your auto insurance.
Right.
Then you should get an online quote from the General right now.
Right.
Rates are low, and you can get insured for as little as $39 a month. And you'll get instant proof of insurance. Are you ready?
For a great low rate you can get online, go to the General and save some time.
Tuesday on National Geographic. This man is on a one-way mission to turn full contact jousting into the next big thing. But outside the arena, the real battle begins.
Don't forget it!
My arm's broken!
These knights will take on anyone.
Back off, I'll take you on! Let's go,
Knights of Mayhem. The all-new series premieres Tuesday at 9 on the National Geographic Channel, Channel 276.
Has a 100-yard kick return. In fact, we did that game against LSU.
Track athlete with great speed, 4.240.
Kerouac to kick it off for the Georgia Bulldogs. This time he kicks it into a slight breeze. This one's returnable. Bounds at the 10, picked up at the 5, and this is Robinson. And he falls. Does not even get back to the 20-yard line. And Adrian Karsten, let's check with you again.
Very special guest from Hart County High, back in Hartwell, Georgia, Bill and Kathy Laird. The emotions of a father watching his son, who's gone 12-3 as a starter here at Auburn, on his final night as a senior at Auburn.
Well, it means a lot to us for him to finish up here. We thought one time we might not ever see this, hope it turns out a little better than it's going right now. But I know he had to have a lot of good feelings walking through that tunnel tonight.
Kathy, you remember some of the memories from the scrapbook and some of the yearbook back at Hart County High. The messages in the letters that we have heard, Ron, Mike, and I, since we've been covering football here, what were some of those messages that really helped Ben in some of his darker times?
Just the fact that everyone pretty much has stayed with him. That's been the most supportive thing.
Making the scrapbook, who's responsible for putting this together? And some of the pictures, including Melanie, his fiancée, when she was captain of the cheerleading squad, as a matter of fact.
His aunt, Ann Bender.
Bill, do you have any hand in this at all?
No, my sister, she worked on it. She does them for my boys. Has been doing it for about 15 years for all four of my boys.
Ron, this has a lot to do with the reunion of two quarterbacks tonight who were 2 years apart back at Hart County High, and the emotions of parents in a college football game.
That's for sure. Nice job, Adrian. Pass intended for Carter, and that one's thrown just a little bit too high.
And we've talked about, Adrian talked about the notes that Kathy, his mother, sends him every week of the ball game. Says a little prayer in it, encouragement, and Ben Laird says he looks forward to reading that, and that gives him motivation to do well in the ball games.
The picture, the young lady, the muffler shop, is engaged to her.
Engaged and in graduate school.
Yeah. Yep. 5 of 10, 36 yards, 2 interceptions. Not a memorable evening so far for Beer. Pressure is on him, going to be sacked, and those defensive linemen, this time Terrence Smith, breaks through and makes the tackle. And right now, let's don't pin everything on Ben Laird. The offensive line is getting manhandled right now by the defensive front of Georgia.
No, and Tommy Tuberville did not want to start this way, because when you have a freshman quarterback on the other side, you want to invite him out to play. He doesn't have to play right now. His defense is covering him up. He's got a 10-0 lead, and they've had great field position. So everything backfiring on Auburn.
Duvall gets a kick away off the side of his foot. Not very far. Bounding just across the 35-yard line, and Auburn's going to have to touch it dead at the 37. Wow. 23 yards and a kick. We'll take a break. 10-0 Georgia. And 9 minutes, 42 seconds left until halftime.
Celebrate another St. Louis Cardinals World Series title with Sports Illustrated's exclusive championship package. You'll get this must-have official 2011 World Series DVD, plus this limited edition hardcover book. Relive the Cardinals' postseason heroics with MLB Productions' amazing video and SI's famous writing and photography. Go to SIOffer.com or call now to get both free with a paid subscription. 56 issues for only $1.59 an issue. Save 65% off the cover price. Use your credit or debit card and get this officially licensed championship baseball honoring the St. Louis Cardinals. Designed exclusively for SI, it features the World Series and team logos, plus a special display cube. Don't miss this terrific offer. Go to SIOffer.com or call now to get the official DVD, the commemorative book, and the collectible baseball. This incredible package is all free and only available from Sports Illustrated. Call or go online now.
How much did you pay for your new car?
What if you could find out what everyone else paid for the car you want before you bought a new car? Well, now you can. Introducing TrueCar.com, the hassle-free, haggle-free, totally free new way to get a guaranteed low price on a new car. Log on to TrueCar.com. Choose the car you want. First, TrueCar.com shows you what others actually paid for the car you're looking for. Then TrueCar.com finds you an even better available price. In minutes, you'll have a TrueCar price protection certificate that you can print out. Take it to a TrueCar certified dealer near you where you can pick up your new car.
I saved $8,300 on TrueCar.com.
TrueCar.com was free.
And we saved a heck of a lot of money.
Took 3 clicks and I knew exactly what I was going to pay for the car that I wanted to buy.
The research is done for you by TrueCar.com.
So log on to the hassle-free, haggle-free, totally free way to buy a new car. That's TrueCar.com.
Heisman hopeful Andrew Luck and the unbeaten Cardinals host division rival Oregon in a high-stakes top 10 showdown with Pac-12 and national championship implications. Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines. Oregon, Stanford, Saturday at 8 on ABC. College football lives here.
Ten to nothing, Georgia. That ball was actually tipped. Now listen, we'll bring up the natural sound and you'll hear the ball hit the foot and then hitting the hand of Charles Grant, number 19. You could hear it hit his big right mitt. You could see Duvall looking back over his head, wanting to know if he blocked it behind him.
Terrence Edwards, it's quarterback. Now this is where I turn the quarterbacks loose a little bit here. Got great field position. You got a 10-0 lead.
High school quarterback, now wide receiver, hands it off on a running play, and that's Jasper Sanks, who continues to fight his way inside the 35-yard line.
You talk about Terrence Edwards. We talked about a quarterback in high school. He threw for 16 touchdowns and ran 96 times for 8 touchdowns. So he's a pretty good athlete. Led Washington County High School to the title in the state of Georgia. Sat out his first year. He moved into wide receiver. He's caught a pass in every game he started.
Corey Phillips watches patiently on the sideline. About to go into 9 minutes left until halftime. Pitches this one and got him in all kind of trouble. That one blew up. because the pressure from Tolbar, and on the option play, the quarterback's got to be parallel to the line of scrimmage. The minute he starts going backwards, it's over.
Auburn's playing option all the way. Now, when Terrence Edwards comes into the football game, you see the depth right here. Once the quarterback gets back here, he's in trouble in pitch relationship and good coverage by the corners. Hood, number 36. Now Corey Phillips back in the ball game on third down. You don't want to give away this great field position.
So from the 42, as you see his numbers, 5 of 5. It's a third down and 16. They roll the pocket, zips it long, has it completed to 21 to Darrell Robinson. 21 yards in the pass play.
Now, he's graduated now. I think you turn him loose. He threw that ball right on the money to Darrell Robinson. Picked up the first down, and now they're in business. Came in with Terrence Edwards to try to run two option plays, hit the fullback Jasper Sanks, then an option. Now Corey Phillips picks up the first down.
And as you can see, Casher had it covered about as well as you can cover it. Quincy Carter nervously watches on the sideline.
Yeah, I talked to him before the ball game run out to follow up after this play.
First down and 10. The ball just inside the Auburn 21. Sanks, left side, boy, running hard.
Talking to Quincy before the ball game, he was really hurt that he's not able to play. And as Adrian said, he's going to try to help Corey Phillips tonight, but he didn't want to talk to him the first two or three series. As he said, everybody will be hovering over him. He said, where I'll help him is in the second quarter and tell him what I see out there and how it is to play here, because he had a good game 2 years ago here.
Edwards and Gary both split out wide to the left. Two tight ends set for Georgia. Sanks ran into his own blocker, still trying to move forward with a second effort. Look at these defensive numbers. Only 60 yards allowed by each defense. But Georgia leads by 10, and they are driving again. Musa Smith in a tailback, and they didn't get this one off. It cost him 5 yards.
And you got to get the play into him a little earlier. Corey Phillips, I'm impressed with him, the way he's playing. Now, he's going up and down with his offensive lineman, explaining the change, and he looks to me like he's got ice water in his veins. He's not bothered by this crowd.
That's the first penalty of the ball game.
Well-officiated game here in the first half. And a good pace of the game, too.
Yeah, it really is. This drive right here, particularly if Georgia would have put it in the end zone. Crowd, as you had mentioned, Mike, trying desperately to help the Auburn Tigers. But they need to keep him out of the end zone here. Here comes a blitz. Gets his pass off. Got it. Should have been caught by McNeil. Good heavens, it hit him right in the hands.
They had everything what they wanted. They had Randy McMichael against Roderick Hood. And you can't throw it any better than that. He couldn't bring it in.
So it's going to be a field goal attempt. Let's see where they place this one down. A 37-yard attempt. 7 of 8 on the year by Bill Bennett. 43 is his longest. Set well. The left footer knocks it up and through. 6:01 left until halftime. Let's take a break at our new score. The Bulldogs 13 and Auburn nothing.
Hi, I'd like to show you two new amazing mechanics products from Craftsman at Sears. Let me ask you, have your sockets ever let you down? If so, check out the new Craftsman Max Access Ratchet and Socket Sets. Our breakthrough design allows them to go where standard and deep sockets can't, saving time, frustration, and money. It's 45% stronger, yet the thinner profile allows for greater access. Now you can do more with less, all covered under the Craftsman Lifetime Warranty. Buy it now for $59.99. Now let's talk raw power and cordless mobility. The Craftsman C3 19.2-volt impact wrench. Boasting 200 foot-pounds of torque, it can tackle anything from rusty lug nuts to sinking huge lag bolts. Jobs usually done with a pneumatic tool. Get it now with battery for just $99.99, only at Sears. So hurry into Sears. Visit us online at sears.com/innovation or call to take advantage of these incredible deals today.
Sears, home of craftsmen.
Wouldn't it be great if you could get everything you needed for your small business for free? Like a building for free, a company car for free, your business website built for free? The cost to have your website professionally built can be thousands of dollars. But for a limited time, you can have yours built by the experts at web.com absolutely free. And that's not all. Web.com will promote your new website in all the major search engines, like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If you're happy with your new website, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for just one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing. Call now to get your new site up and running in as little as 7 days free. Over 1 million small businesses rely on web.com every day. Call now and find out why.
Call 1-800-862-9531 today. That's 1-800-862-9531.
Two elite teams battle aboard the USS Carl Vinson. Michigan State versus preseason number one, North Carolina. The Quicken Loans Carrier Classic, Friday at 7 on ESPN.
Played very well in the first half. Defense has played well.
Jim Donnan continues to pace on the sideline. His ball club up 13-0. 10 of those points had come because of turnovers. Damon Duvall, a sophomore out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. We gave you the numbers. Career long 47. This is going to be a 48-yard attempt. Good pass. Boy, he knocked it long and high and good. So some momentum for the Auburn Tigers as we head to the locker room and halftime. Our score at halftime is Georgia 13 and Auburn 3.
Hi, I'm Montel Williams from Money Mutual, your trusted source to over 60 lenders that can get you up to $1,000 in your checking account by tomorrow. These are tough times. And if you're facing an unexpected car repair bill, a medical emergency, or you just need extra cash to hold you over until payday, then you need to know about Money Mutual, an easy way to get short-term cash fast. So forget about bounced checks, overdraft charges, and late fees. Need cash tomorrow? Call 1-800-585-CASH today.
Tonight on ABC, it's time for the country to cut loose. The CMA Awards, with performances by Taylor Swift, Blake Shelton, Carrie Underwood, Jason Aldean, Scotty McCreery, Lady Antebellum, plus Brad Paisley, Vince Gill, and Keith Urban, with a special tribute to Glenn Campbell. And for the first time in 5 years, Faith Hill returns to the CMA stage. Hosted by Brad and Carrie, the CMA Awards, live tonight, 8, 7 Central on ABC.
If you like video games, you need to be a member of Gamefly.
Real gamers talk about why they love Gamefly.
You just go online, put games in your GameCube.
They come in the mail.
You get to keep it as long as you want. Ship it out, and you get your next one.
Join Gamefly now with this special TV offer and get all the games you want delivered right to your home for one low monthly fee.
Due dates? None. Late fees? Non-existent.
With over 8,000 titles, Gamefly is the best way to rent video games.
First-person shooters, RPGs, multiplayer games.
Access to every single game I could possibly imagine, and I get it for a low cost.
Get started at Gamefly.com now. Save money and play your favorite games all year long.
Gamefly is a great value.
You get more than what you pay for.
Want to own a game you're playing? Buy it from Gamefly for a discounted price.
I buy almost all my games from Gamefly now.
Nice thing is you don't even buy it for full price.
Go to Gamefly.com now. Click the joystick in the top right corner. Enter All-Star in the box and get started with a free extended trial. And remember, you can cancel at any time. Product shown rated E through M.
You have to have this service. You call yourself a gamer, you have to have it.
13-3 as we prepare to start the third quarter here at Auburn, Alabama. And the quarterbacks, well, they're the ones we talked about off the top of the telecast tonight. And Mike, what do you see here as far as the comparisons?
Well, Corey Phillips has had the better evening because he hasn't made any mistakes. Ben Laird, whose team really needs him to complete some passes against this zone coverage, he's had two big interceptions.
Well, we've talked about the fact that Auburn looked a little flat in the first half, but when you look, their defense held Georgia to under 100 yards in total offense.
Did a good job. They can't run the ball, though. They can't get Rudy Johnson unleashed. They have to give him in the second half here. Here's Ben Laird's first interception and went for a touchdown. I just got away from him. Here's the second one where he drops the ball, and then Wansley comes in and picks that off. A little late on the throw, and Ben Lair, the emotional leader of this Auburn team, needs to have some success here in the second half.
Neither team with 100 yards in the first half.
You know, and there's a statistic on the rushing for Auburn. They gained the first four carries. They had 19 yards. Looked like they were going to be able to run the ball. And then the last 10 carries, they've gotten 1 yard. So a good adjustment by Gary Gibbs and the Georgia defensive staff.
Kerouac prepares to kick it off. Robinson along with Roderick Hood back deep. Taken by Hood. 35. Back to the middle of the field, across the 40, and Ben Laird is going to have excellent field position after a 35-yard return. Adrian Karsten, what do you have for us?
Ron, I have the first half report card on Corey Phillips as submitted by head coach and teacher Jim Dunn. Ball handling, A. Game management, A. Carrying out your fakes, B. Passing accuracy, B+. Running the option, D, maybe D minus. But he said, you know, if I'm comparing him to Quincy Carter running the option at this point, if that's the worst thing in the world, fine. I want him to start all over again in the second half like it's a brand new ball game.
Certainly has been cool. Right now, let's see what Ben Laird can do and right himself, because he got off on a wrong foot in that opening drive. As you look at Johnson, has five, has 10, and he's loose. At the 20, 15, 10, at the 5-yard line, is tackled from behind. It's a 55-yard run.
Before that run, Rudy Johnson had gained 23 yards. His longest run was 9 yards. Vieira, number 15, will catch him at about the 4-yard line. So Rudy Johnson has brought this crowd back into the football game.
Well, for sure, because they had started to slumber, but it was the Auburn team on the field that caused them to slumber. First and goal from the 4. Johnson, right up the gut, nothing. 97 Stroud, all kinds of penetration.
Ronnie Daniels has entered the ball game too, Ron. He's been in on the last two plays. Looks like he's limping a little bit, but in the game.
I guess if nothing else, to have him there as a decoy could be a help.
Marcel Willis has the best vertical jump on this football team, number 80.
Play action. Laird lobs for the end zone. In and out of the hands. Worthy was there, but I'm not sure. There were two receivers right there together.
Somebody busted the route, because you don't want two receivers. You had Robert Johnson, a tight end, and Reggie Worthy, number 4, in the same area. Ben Laird with a pretty good fake. Everybody's now worried about Rudy Johnson. But you see both receivers, and that brings in an extra defender.
So it's third down and goal. Keith Evans in the ball game, number 44. Laird delivers. Touchdown, Worthy. Millard really hit Ben Laird just after he threw it, but he gets the touchdown. And less than a minute and a half into the second half of play, all of a sudden Auburn has got the faithful up and roaring.
Good throw by Ben Laird. Right on time to Reggie Worthy. He's right inside the goal line for the touchdown.
Damon Duvall to attempt the extra point and try to make this a field goal ball game.
Injury timeout.
Cap Burnett, number 23, looks to be hurt. And that's why the officials are calling the timeout. Rudy Johnson gave this Auburn team a big lift with that run. Well blocked.
It really was, because for the first time tonight, those two the two tackles did not dictate what happened in the inside carry. Rudy Johnson, a 14 attempts, 75 yards.
And you talked about the field goal just before half. That gives you enough to go in the locker room with everything's positive, and then you came out and you get a score. So everything looks up for Tommy Tuberville. And they're going to get a penalty on the running into the kicker.
It's Jamie Henderson who ran into the kicker. Extra point is good. It's a 13-10 ball game. Duvall prepares to kick it off. And Mike, we saw an onside kick by Tommy Tuberville in the Ole Miss game. 15-yard penalty. It's out at the 50. You think he'll do it again?
Got a chance. Looks like he's going to kick it out of the end zone. I always wonder why they don't pooch kick that, because you got great field position anyway, but redshirt freshman or the young quarterback, that's, they're trying to put him in the hole.
Adrian Carson, what do you have for us?
Well, Corey Phillips is not playing, is playing rather tonight because Quincy Carter can't. Very different situation now, Quincy, for Corey. I know you've been helping him in the first half. How did you coach him in the first half?
Well, you know, I just told Corey he just needed to settle down. Corey's doing a great job right now. He's seeing everything. They're making a little run right now, so it's important for Corey to just stay poised and relax.
What's his game plan now in this third quarter?
Right now, we just want to keep doing the same thing we've been doing in the first half. Seems like everything is working, so just keep Corey relaxed.
He really looked like deer in the headlights to me yesterday when we had him one-on-one. How's his air? Is he nervous at all here tonight?
I don't think so. You know, Corey's been pretty relaxed all week. He did a good job against Kentucky stepping in, so he's been in this situation before.
Coach Donnan told me at halftime the one thing he'd give him a D on, rate him below average, is running the option. Who might he be thinking about there?
I don't know. But, you know, we'll just have to see what we get in the second half. You know, I don't want to get too much of the game playing away, so we'll see what's open in the second
half. What's the prognosis for next week? You've got this cast on. It looks like it's a two-week deal. Are you going to play next week or not?
I'm not sure. You know, that's right now it's up in there. You know, us and the doctors got to talk about it, so we'll just see for next week.
You get yourself healthy. Thanks for the time, Quincy.
Right, thank you, Adrian.
Nice move by Damian Gary. Not going to have the first down, but he'll bring him to within about 2.5.
And just a nice young man, Quincy Carter. I talked to him about whether he's going to come back next year. And so that kind of is up in the air a little bit. We hope he gets back. But Corey Phillips has done what they needed him to do in the first half. Now, as the game gets a little closer, he's going to have to start making more plays for the Georgia offense.
So the situation here, it's third down. And about 2.5, they need to take it to the 30.
No, Ron, we were real impressed with Musa Smith. He has not really done anything tonight. Hard running back.
Had to have his knee scoped. Here he gets the handoff, and he's very close to the first down. In fact, I'm surprised that he is able to come back. He is only a freshman out of Elliottsburg, Pennsylvania. 6'1", 208 pounds, and the coaching staff seems to think that he's going to bring a lot to the table in the next 3 years. Did not make the first down. Georgia will punt it away.
This game has turned a little bit on the special teams of Auburn. They get another chance here to return the punt, but they got a good kickoff return to start the second half.
Kilgo, his fourth punt of the night. Clifton Robinson is the deep man. He has dropped off to the 35-yard line. This is a good high driving spiral. Fair catch called for and made at the 28. So we'll take a timeout following that 43-yard punt. 12:05 left in the third quarter. Georgia by 3.
21st Century Insurance here with proof that many of you are paying too much for your car insurance. These two cars have the same coverage, one through Allstate, the other through 21st Century. Both cars are covered, so both cars get the same repairs. Here's the difference, though. Drivers who switch from Allstate to 21st save an average of $516 a year for the same coverage. Aha, you say, but what if I don't have Allstate? Well, that's okay, because drivers who switch from Progressive to 21st save even more. Call 21st Century right now if you're near a phone, and really, who isn't these days? At 888-GET-2121, that's 888-GET-2121. Or visit 21st.com. 21st Century Auto Insurance, the same great coverage for less.
much did you pay for your new car?
What if you could find out what everyone else paid for the car you want before you bought a new car? Well, now you can. Introducing TrueCar.com, the hassle-free, haggle-free, totally free new way to get a guaranteed low price on a new car. Log on to TrueCar.com. Choose the car you want. First, TrueCar.com shows you what others actually paid for the car you're looking for. Then TrueCar.com finds you an even better available price. In minutes, you'll have a TrueCar price protection certificate that you can print out. Take it to a TrueCar certified dealer near you where you can pick up your new car.
I saved $8,300 on TrueCar.com. TrueCar.com was free.
And we saved a heck of a lot of money.
Took three clicks and I knew exactly what I was going to pay for the car that I wanted to buy.
The research is done for you by TrueCar.com.
So log on to the hassle-free, haggle-free, totally free way to buy a new car. That's TrueCar.com.
Prior to that run, they had only 20 yards rushing for the first two quarters. Fakes it to Johnson this time, on the roll, gets it to Johnson to tie it in, and he will take it across the 35 to the 36.
Once you have success with Rudy Johnson running to the right, now you come back off of that with the play-action fake and then hit the tight end Robert Johnson. Now, Robert Johnson's like having a wide receiver. He practices the routes with the wide receivers because he is such a good athlete at 6'6", 254.
Yeah, they get some great-looking specimens at tight end. Johnson, Rudy, has the first down. Close to the 45-yard line, Jermaine Phillips will spin him down.
Well, you talked about the first drive. They hit Rudy Johnson in a couple runs there. And when they run the ball well with Rudy Johnson, it opens up everything else. And Ben Laird's a different quarterback when he has the running game going.
What a difference a first half and now early in the second half can make. 63 yards already in the second half of play. They give it to him again, stretch the play, crosses the 50, down to around the 45-yard line. Hart McGarry with a very good block. Mike, talk about what they do on a play like that where you do stretch it. And you got to, what, just get a little bit of a seal on that big tackle, and then you're...
Where they're doing a good job on Josh Millard, number 98. They're able to seal him inside, and they're able to get into the boundary. Now, they've run into the boundary the last couple times. Helmet on the helmet.
Johnson, they bring him back to the near side, and not much there this time. Vieira, one of the first men, and also off the bottom of the pile is Tony Gilbert, number 42.
All they needed was a running back here. They have been very poor in the running game. 99, averaged 1.9 yards, which was last in the nation. This year, you can see the change in the offensive line and Rudy Johnson. Eddie Grand, the running back coach, recruited Rudy.
Well, they got 94 yards tonight. Second down and 7. See the clock about to go under 10 minutes left third quarter. Johnson breaks off one tackle, but the penetration was there. He is going to have the first down, though. Stroud is the man who got the penetration.
He had a chance at him, Ron, but he had to get him by the neck. And Rudy Johnson, just a too hard a runner and a lower body strength. See number 97 grabbing at the shoulder pads, and then he bounces off Charles Grant. And this is where, once you get him running, second half is when he makes his hay.
The coaches have talked about this so much here at Auburn, that the third and fourth quarter check his yardage compared to the first half. 9 100 yard plus rushing game, school record. Play action, going to reverse it out. Complete. That is Lorenzo Diamond, the tight end, and he is down close to the 25-yard line. Jermaine Phillips made the tackle.
When you get your running game going, all of a sudden the linebackers move in regard to Rudy Johnson. That opens up the passing lane. Now there's no linebacker there. Lorenzo Diamond with an easy catch.
Well, this time Rudy Johnson hit behind the line of scrimmage, broke the tackle of Seymour, and finally going to be knocked out of bounds. After a short game, Millard finally got it. Seymour again with penetration. Stroud and Seymour both getting penetration, but not always able to knock down number 32.
Slanting into the boundary, Ron. They expect a run to go into the boundary, so they're slanting those two big tackles into the short side of the field.
Looks like Stroud is shaken up.
Now, this is a wise thing by Rodney Garner to take them out a little bit, give them a little bit of a rest.
Evans, the lone setback this time, and they give it to him right up the middle, breaks a tackle, breaks a second. Flag is down at the line of scrimmage. This crowd really likes Heath Evans because they have seen him play through injuries, all kinds of hurts, and he's one of those type of kids. Coaches love him. All he says is, just give me the ball and I will do something with it. He's the greatest can-do attitude guy you can have on a team.
And he blocks a lot, Ron. He doesn't get the football much. 29 carries coming into this ball game tonight. So give him 30 carries.
Defense, offside. Be a 5-yard penalty. Remain second down.
Well, tonight's Aflac trivia question comes from a suggestion on the Ask Adrian website. Who was the last Auburn quarterback to defeat Georgia in consecutive seasons? We'll have that answer later on. Are we giving something away here, guys? Just a guess, huh? Second down at about 4. Johnson gets it outside, and a nice job in the secondary. Number 5, Jermaine Phillips came up and helped stop that one very, very quickly. It looked as though they had sealed the inside.
They did, Ron, and when you seal the inside, of course, the linebacker's going to come off the ball. The number 87, Robert Johnson, here's the block. Now, you got the seal on the inside, but both linebackers are going to scrape outside. And Hollinshed again gets help in the secondary from Jermaine Phillips.
Tony Gilbert took a pretty good shot there from the tight end who came over to help out. Eighth play. This started back at the Auburn 28-yard line. It's third down and 3. Right over the middle, incomplete. Boy, DeAndre Green, the intended receiver.
They got to go for this, Ron, I believe. Field goal-wise, it's a choice right here. Kick the field goal, tie it up.
Bill Duvall is coming on the field. Now you'd never know when Tommy Tuberville is going to do what it appears when it comes to special teams. This attempt is 37 yards.
I think he's going to kick this one to try to tie this game up.
Good pass. And looks as though he's done it again. Hit one from 48 just at the end of the first half and now knocks this one home from 37 yards. And at 7:33 left in the third quarter, we are tied at 13. Right back.
Can't seem to find the right size wrench? Are you tired of searching for the right tool? Introducing the Loggerhead Bionic Wrench. It's 14 wrenches in one. Any size, just squeeze and turn. The patented design produces a powerful mechanical advantage. Pliers and adjustable wrenches can strip the corners, but that won't stop the Bionic because it grips on all 6 sides. Simply squeeze and turn. American made and a proven winner. No more guessing. Easy to use. Adjust like pliers. The Bionic Wrench is 14 wrenches in one. Everyone needs one, at home or on the road. With patented gripping power, the Bionic grips them all. It's a gripping experience. Countless uses for the Bionic wrench. Makes a great gift for everyone on your holiday list. 100% American made, limited lifetime warranty. Get the Bionic Wrench today for only $19.99 at Sears. Hurry into Sears. Visit us online at sears.com/innovation or call for this incredible offer.
Wouldn't it be great if you could get everything you needed for your small business for free? Like a building for free, a company car for free, your business website built for free? The cost to have your website professionally built can be thousands of dollars, but for a limited time, you can have yours built by the experts at web.com absolutely free. And that's not all. Web.com will promote your new website in all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If you're happy with your new website, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for just one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing. Call now to get your new site up and running in as little as 7 days free. Over 1 million small businesses rely on web.com every day. Call now and find out why.
Call 1-800-862-9531 today. That's 1-800-862-9531.
Heisman hopeful Andrew Luck and the unbeaten Cardinal host division rival Oregon in a high-stakes top 10 showdown with Pac-12 and national championship implications. Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines. Oregon, Stanford, Saturday at 8 on ABC. College football lives here.
We're now tied at 13. A little story. David Housel, who's the athletic director here, former sports information director, writes a column for every game and game program. And he makes a very astute observation that UGA, the initial UGA, was given to the University of Georgia by an Auburn man. So the tie is very direct. Again, you talked about how close you saw the kids shaking hands and hugging tonight, that the proximity. Obviously, everybody very, very close. So even in mascots.
I want Adrian to interview UGA because he's got a sweater deal with Russell. He's the only dog I know with a sweater deal.
Thornton and Milliken, the two men back deep. Very high kick, 1 yard deep, and it'll be Thornton who will return it. Wow, what a hit just prior to the 20-yard line. And that is Heath Evans, the man we were just talking about, who plays fullback and also plays special teams. But whatever he plays with a great fervor. His motor is running.
New ball game.
Sacks hit at the line of scrimmage. And they're going to give him the line of scrimmage, but that's it as Rob Pate, a very steady player for Auburn, comes over to make the tackle.
And that's the other thing now that's going to happen. Auburn's going to play eight people in the box. They're not going to let Georgia run the ball. They're going to say now to Jim Donnan, let Corey Phillips prove he can beat us. And I was impressed with Corey Phillips in the first half. He can beat you.
Good look at DeMarco McNeil. Redshirt freshman out of Pritchard. Second down and 10. The ball just shy of the 20-yard line. Blitz is on. Right up in the middle. Got it in and out of the hands of Javaris Johnson. Oh, my goodness. Jim Donnan's just got to have his heart pounding. He had the play. It worked beautifully. The young quarterback put it right in his hands.
Auburn's going to come after the quarterback right here. You see the pressure. Here comes Pate on the blitz. Corey Phillips stays right in there. Ball's got to be caught. Stanford Simmons, number 8, deflecting the ball away from Javaris Johnson, or I'm not sure, he just didn't drop it.
9 of 13, 67 yards for Corey Phillips. It is third down. The line to make, the 29.5-yard line. We're tied at 13, and we have 6:31 to play, third quarter.
Here's your leading receiver right there, Terrence Edwards.
That's who he wants, and he underthrew it.
Now, Terrence Edwards wants a holding call. He was held coming out, but he's not going to get the call. Corey Phillips trying to look for the leading receiver, Roderick Hood, on coverage, and this Auburn crowd now is alive in this football game. Here's Terrence Edwards. There's what he was referring to. There's the hold.
Yep, twice. Yep. Fifth punt by Jonathan Kilgoe. Clifton Robinson, the deep man. So Edwards was correct in protesting, but no good. Hanging spiral, good coverage kick, and catch is made. This is going to be a 5-yard delay of game penalty for the Halo violation. Davis tried to get away from him, but he was slipping down, and he was already within the 2-yard barrier.
Would $1,000 in your checking account today bring you relief tomorrow? Hi, I'm Warren Moon, a proud member of the Pro Money Source team. Click or call us, and within 24 hours, we can get you up to $1,000 deposited directly into your bank account. Think of it. Rent, paid. Child care costs, paid. Household expenses, paid. Pro Money Source connects you to hundreds of lenders. Click or call now and get cash in your bank account today.
Hey, guys, I got something.
Freaky.
Hey, we found these cool helmets, but we think they might be cursed.
Because they won't come off.
That's not good.
Lions and bears at war?
The rivalry goes back further than we ever could have imagined.
All right, Chris, bring in the dynamite. We're going to get this thing to Canton.
Sunday NFL Countdown, presented by IBM. Sundays at 10 a.m. on ESPN.
Here's the idea. When anybody in America calls Quicken Loans for a free home loan review, we'll offer them a free Android smartphone.
But how are you going to get these phones to our clients coast to coast?
Dan, it's going to take a little magic.
Don't worry about it. I'm on it.
Straight from Motown to you, America. Quicken Loans, helping people coast to coast. Here's an Android for Alaska.
Show them that Motown magic.
Send it to me Spartan style for down south.
Yes. That's nice right there.
Helping folks in all 50 states.
Give me what you got now.
Magic, you getting tired yet?
I'm just getting warmed up.
It's like magic. Call today for a free home loan review. We'll offer a free Android smartphone to you.
Hit it!
Here's one for the East Coast.
Now that's some Detroit magic right there.
One more way, Quicken Loans is engine.
Chilly night, and everybody's got a fire going here. But here's a little contest for you. Which one is live and which one is Memorex? Actually, this is right down by our audio tent. Ray Stottel is warming himself. That's not a real fire, but that is a real marshmallow. But we wondered why it wouldn't get brown. The final 15 minutes, third down and 6. The ball just outside the 10. From the shotgun. Laird under heavy pressure drills it. Touchdown, Daniels. Seymour with tremendous pressure. But the situation is whatever Noel Mazzone decided they were going to do, it has worked. That is 4 straight possessions they have scored on.
And the difference in this second half is Ben Laird. Ben Laird has played to a high percentage here in the second half.
Damon Duvall to attempt the extra point. Good pass. Knocks it home. This is an Auburn team that slumbered through the first almost 30 minutes of play. And now they have scored on 4 straight possessions to go on top by a count of 20-13. We're coming right back.
First Century Insurance here with the, I think, our fastest way yet to prove that you can save hundreds of dollars just by switching your car insurance. You start with 2 identical cars, one covered by a leading insurance provider, the other covered by 21st Century. Both cars have the same damage, but here's the fun part. You see, they both have the same coverage, so they both get the same fast, hassle-free repairs. Although, I have to confess, I've never seen my mechanic move like that. And done. Same car, same damage, same repairs, but drivers who switch from GEICO to 21st don't pay the same premiums. No, they save an average of $492 a year. And drivers who switch from Progressive, they save even more. Call 888-GET-2121. That's 888-GET-2121. Or try us online at 21st.com. 21st Century Auto Insurance. The same great coverage for less.
Hi, I'm Montel Williams from Money Mutual, your trusted source to over 60 lenders that can get you up to $1,000 in your checking account by tomorrow. These are tough times, and if you're facing an unexpected car repair bill, a medical emergency, or you just need extra cash to hold you over until payday, then you need to know about Money Mutual, an easy way to get short-term cash fast. So forget about bounced checks, overdraft charges, and late fees. Need cash tomorrow? Call 1-800-585-CASH today.
Did you pay for your new car?
What if you could find out what everyone else paid for the car you want before you bought a new car? Well, now you can. Introducing TrueCar.com, the hassle-free, haggle-free, totally free new way to get a guaranteed low price on a new car. Log on to TrueCar.com. Choose the car you want. First, TrueCar.com shows you what others actually paid for the car you're looking for. Then TrueCar.com finds you an even better available price. In minutes, you'll have a TrueCar price protection certificate that you can print out. Take it to a TrueCar certified dealer near you where you can pick up your new car.
I saved $8,300 on TrueCar.com. TrueCar.com was free.
And we saved a heck of a lot of money.
Took three clicks and I knew exactly what I was going to pay for the car that I wanted to buy.
The research is done for you by TrueCar.com.
So log on to the hassle-free, haggle-free, totally free way to buy a new car. That's TrueCar.com.
Georgia, for the most part, owned the first half. The second half, it's been the Tigers of Auburn. And we have 14:55 to play in our ball game. We'll see if the Dogs can wrestle the momentum back. From the goal line, it's Thornton. Keith Evans, and he's going to be penalized for hitting him out of bounds.
The difference in both these offenses, Rudy Johnson. You got the running game going the second half. Georgia has not been able to run the football.
Well, the answer to tonight's Aflac trivia question, who was the last Auburn quarterback to defeat Georgia in consecutive seasons? Actually, Reggie Slack, 1988 and 1989. In fact, he went 6-0 against Georgia, Florida, and Alabama those 2 years. By the way, a thanks to Ashley Weaver for that suggestion on the Ask Adrian website. If you look at Pat Sullivan.
Tried to throw you off.
Yeah, they did. Georgia rushing this half. 4 carries, 18 yards.
Yeah, that's been the difference in the game. You can't lay this quarterback out here like that, Corey Phillips, without giving him some opportunity to run the football. Now he's got to drop back and get this passing game going.
Dumps it off to Sanks. And Jasper will take it out across the 35. That's McNeil defensively. Second and 7. This pass complete, and that's Robinson, but not for very much. Didn't get out of bounds at the 37.
Good tackle by Larry Casher right after the catch. Long way to throw the ball in college football when you throw from the left hash mark and throw it all the way to the wide side of the field. Larry Casher is going to make the play break on it. Darrell Robinson with a catch. Big, big third down for the young quarterback.
Remember that same pattern run by Florida State with Outsen in the national championship game, and it was picked off in return for a touchdown. Casher now 7 tackles, all solo. Third and 5, line to make the 42. Pressure is on, and it is picked off by Pate. Rob Pate with the interception.
Alton Moore pressured the quarterback. James Collier, the linebacker, got Corey Phillips moving to the left. He threw across his body. You watch his play now. Here's the pressure, the blitz. Now they get him moving. Now he throws off his foot. Back foot gets it picked off by Rob Pate. Good defensive call by the Auburn staff.
Good job by Pate to get a hand underneath that football. Look at this hit.
That's what they didn't do in the first half because Corey Phillips had the lead. Now they're forcing him into making mistakes.
Play action by Laird. Dumps it off. And he's got to his tight end Diamond, who maintained his balance. It's going to be a gain of 11 yards. Adrian, what do you have for us?
Not a severe injury, but slight to Ben Laird. Sore right knee, Ron. Had he bent that back any further in the previous offensive series, they would have called it a hyperextension. He just came over. It's a little cool down here. He's not like playing in cold weather. Just starting to tighten up a little bit. He said the best thing he can do is to get back in the game, keep moving around on it. So far, no real lack of stability, if I see that, Ron.
Okay. 13 minutes left in our ball game. Auburn trying to capitalize off a turnover.
Maybe at halftime he read that note again from his mother, because he's playing like he's been encouraged.
Rudy Johnson, not much there, and it is Biera. He will get penetration and hitting behind the line of scrimmage is Millard, and Stroud also putting a lot of pressure and forcing the play back farther behind the line of scrimmage.
This Georgia defense knows they can't give up many more points, because their offense can't run the ball tonight. You got a young quarterback.
Mike Biera now has 7 tackles, 5 solo, and a touchdown return of 75 yards with the interception. But Pate coming up with a big move just a moment ago. Laird drills it, incomplete. Crowd wanted something there. Wansley was there very quickly. I think Charles Grant tipped that ball, and that's the reason pass interference was off.
Yeah, I would not question this crew. They've been on everything tonight. Now the crowd's booing here. Let's see if they could have been interference, Ron. McMichael looks like he got his legs tied up with the...
You're right, even before the ball could have been tipped. So it's third down and 14. They need to take it to the 18 and a half yard line. Laird looks for the end zone, and it is knocked away by a nice defensive play by Corey Robinson, number 26, a senior out of Tucker, Georgia.
Tried to get the ball to DeAndre Green, put it up for jump ball, but they're going to force the field goal attempt here. Ben Laird trying to get the ball deep. Just became a jump ball.
Yeah, DeAndre Green actually played a little bit of defensive back there and knocking the ball down so it wouldn't be picked off.
Damon Duvall, who's been hot tonight. And he's had good distance on his kicks. Going to need it here.
It's going to be a new personal best if he hits it. 49 yards. He's already hit one from 48. Good pass, and he stroked another one. You can see the Auburn people up and cheering already. 48, 49 yards. Damon Duvall showing some strength that he has not shown prior to this evening. Accuracy, yes, but not this kind of distance. And all of a sudden, Auburn is up by 10 points. Let's take a timeout. 11:56. Left in our ball game, and the new score, Auburn 23, Georgia 13.
When you need power this big in a space this small, you need award-winning Craftsman innovation. Sears presents the revolutionary Craftsman Nextech Right Angle Impact Driver. It has the best power-to-weight ratio in its class and delivers 700 inch-pounds of torque and 3,400 impacts per minute right where you need it, to make driving even 3-inch lag bolts a snap. Its innovative impact mechanism and right angle design let you work at the most challenging angles in the smallest spaces. Plus, it delivers twice the torque of a conventional drill without twisting your wrist. It's ready when you are, thanks to its long-life lithium-ion battery. Get the Craftsman Right Angle Impact Driver for just $99.99 and receive this Craftsman 12-volt drill free, a $49 value. It's compact, yet powerful enough for everyday jobs. Hurry into Sears. Visit us online at sears.com/innovation or call for this incredible offer. Sears, home of Craftsman.
Is your computer running slowly? Does it take more than 3 seconds for your email to load?
Are you frustrated with error messages, blue screens, computer freezes and crashes? These are not only annoying, but can cause permanent damage to your computer.
If you're experiencing any of these symptoms, your computer and your privacy may be at risk, because these are usually the telltale signs of a virus, and it can only get worse until you act. Get a free diagnosis at mycleanpc.com.
My Clean PC is outstanding, and my computer is running faster than ever.
My Clean PC came through with flying colors when no one else could.
My Clean PC totally cleaned up my system and increased my speed.
MyCleanPC.com can remove spyware, viruses, and infected emails, all speeding up your PC's performance. It offers all-in-one protection, and it's been downloaded by millions of users.
Even if you have antivirus software, your computer could still be infected. Find out instantly with a free comprehensive diagnosis at MyCleanPC.com.
Mike, I just want to show you, it may be snowing up in Manhattan, Kansas. That's not ice or snow, that's Vaseline they have on the goalpost here at Auburn. And you know, frankly, it is, boy, it's fun for the kids and all that kind of stuff, but it's also dangerous. It is very dangerous.
Ron, one thing dangerous for Georgia right now, you don't want an interception because you want to at least come away with three here.
You don't want an interception and you don't want a sack.
No.
Third down and 15. Sets for the end zone. He's got him. Edwards for the touchdown. Four catches in that drive for Edwards. What a clutch performance by him. And all of a sudden, with the extra point, we got a field goal ball game.
You want a touchdown is what you want. You don't want an interception. You don't want a sack. If you're a Georgia fan, you want a touchdown. And Terrence Edwards has been more involved in this entire series. It's down the middle. Wide open for the touchdown. You got to credit Corey Phillips. Now Auburn got to find a way to burn 5-16.
Good pass. Billy Bennett splits him. So with 5 minutes, 16 seconds left in our ball game, it is a brand new ball game. The Auburn Tigers 23 and the Georgia Bulldogs 20. In this, the 104th meeting between these two schools.
Terrence Edwards, it's an empty set. Nobody in the backfield. Corey Phillips does a nice job of looking off. And I believe he got the linebacker there just to move a little bit.
And his
Alex
parents,
Lincoln.
His parents are extremely excited.
Hugs for everybody. Now Auburn. You know, Tommy Tuberville's got pressures on his quarterback from Georgia, Ben Laird.
8 plays, 42 yards, 2 minutes, 45 seconds. Edwards, as we told you, 4 receptions on that drive. This one 2 yards deep. He is going to return it. That's Hood. And here comes a flag. So the bottom line is Hood, 2 yards deep, probably should have taken a knee there because instead of getting to 20-yard line, this penalty is going to put it back around the 10-yard line. And as we suggested, I tell you, Mike, that's not going to be at the 10. They put that thing all the way back to the 5-yard line.
Just thinking about Nebraska's loss, how that's going to, again, jumble up the top six teams. You'd think Oregon would get up there a little closer.
That makes the Civil War next week in the state of Oregon even bigger, doesn't it?
Now, Oregon State's got to get by Arizona tonight, which I don't believe they've ever won it at Arizona.
No.
So they're going to have to do a first. Miami looked very good today. And Florida State struggled a little bit with Wake Forest in the first half, but then cleared them out in the second half.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. We get to see that Miami ball club next Saturday night. We're at the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York. And talk about no bargain. That Syracuse defense is no bargain. Rudy Johnson. Spins off one tackle. Stroud gets him. It was Evans who had him first.
Ron, go back to that. The events that changed this field position around that got Georgia back in this football game. Jonathan Kilgo with the long punt that you talked about. He knocked it over 60. Then the block punt, that changed the field around for Georgia. So Georgia's special team, which has been beaten most of this football game, really came up big with two big plays. And now, if they hold Auburn down here,
look at all these numbers right there. Tip punt, block punt.
Big, yeah.
Two punts of over 60 yards.
Usually talk about it at the beginning of the season.
Short drop and the pass. Did he catch it? Yes, he did. That's DeAndre Green. And let's don't leave out Duvall. We've talked about him. What a great, consistent job by him tonight. So the kickers have been asked to perform and have responded extremely well. There are the timeouts. Georgia with two, Auburn with three. Clock now under 4 minutes to play.
This may be the biggest third down of both these teams' season.
I know there are a lot of bowl representatives here tonight.
They got all the seats tonight. Peach Bowl, I know. I saw them back there. Sugar Bowl, Citrus Bowl.
Outback Bowl. Laird's pass, too far. Reggie Worthy, the intended receiver. And you can see the celebration over there on the Georgia side for their defense. And this young man is going to get another opportunity. Corey Phillips, with under 3.5 minutes to play, his offense will get another shot.
And remember, they have had trouble punting the football tonight. Georgia has tipped one and blocked one and came close on about three other ones.
So let's keep an eye. Auburn quickly gets a special teams player off the field. They had one too many. Good pass, and he rapidly gets this one away. Great high coverage kick. Signals for the fair catch and makes it at the 41, Damian Gary. 47 yards in the punt. So again, the special teams kickers come through big time. Adrian Carson, what do you have for us, buddy?
Well, with all the emotion, consider what Auburn has played with tonight. Ron, I can tell you from personal experience, one of the reasons I came with so much emotion was because some of the 15 most extravagant minutes in college football. It's called the Tiger Walk. You don't get to do this unless you get the invitation from the head coach. So I accepted it. And Ron, I got to tell you what. No, I didn't play football at Auburn, but people with tears in their eyes, giving you high fives, slapping you on the back. What an emotional experience. If you can't get up for a game here after doing the Tiger Walk, well, then something's wrong. Just a fantastic moment in college football for me.
That's great. That's great, Adrian. You've been a busy guy today.
He has. He's done it all.
Phillips drills the pass complete, and it's going to be maybe a game of two to LeBron Mitchell.
Adrian did play at
Northwestern.
So yeah. A lot of people looked at him today and said, is that our new tackle? Or?
Well, I have to confess that last night when he was over doing the Georgia player interviews, that Coach Donnan invited him to go to the pregame meal table, which they didn't have to twist his arm, and I get a record report out of how much food he ate.
He ate more than Stroud and Seymour.
Second down and nine. Right over the middle, got him. That is Reggie Brown, and boy, does he get hit. Walker, one of the first men to get there on Brown, who was not a real big guy.
A lot of times you want your receiver, like Reggie Brown, instead of taking it to the sideline, dart up inside, get all you can get, because we're going to come down to third two, Jim Donnan's team. Now Auburn defensively looking for a stop. 2:15. This is two down territory here.
Brown's out there. Going to run the middle screen. Had the blockers set up. And it maybe was a little too high, but he should have caught the football.
Ron, there's 2:04 on the clock. And you've got all. Georgia's got two timeouts left. They got to go for this.
Auburn 23, Georgia 20. 2 minutes and 4 seconds left. Home team has not won since 1991.
Well, it comes down to this.
They need to take it to the 48.5-yard line to pick up the first down. Phillips drills it complete. That's Gary, and it's first down, and Georgia moves the chains. Good for 11 yards.
And we talked about Corey Phillips this entire ball game. Not phased, not excited. Second start of the season. Replacing Quincy Carter. Throws a bullet for a first down.
Two young men went to the same high school. Yep.
They met at the middle of the field before the ball game. Talked.
Ben Laird and Corey Phillips, of course, who we're talking about. High pass, he gathers it over the middle. Intercepted. Brown, Mark Brown, and there is a flag down.
Flag in the secondary. That's either got to be a pick or a hold on Auburn or a pick on Georgia. Bad snap for Corey Phillips. He never got a chance to look down the field to see what the coverage was. Flag sitting about the 21-yard line.
Georgia's celebrating.
They might have too many men on the field.
Yep. Against the blue. Be a 5-yard penalty. Remain first down.
Tried to get somebody off the field, Ron. And that's what it was. Here's the player for Auburn trying to get off the field.
That's McNeil, isn't it?
Didn't get off.
Either Tarver 82 or McNeil 92. Hard to tell from that angle.
And keeps the drive now. Gets first and five.
Clock shows a minute and 36 seconds left. First down and five. Biggest thing for Georgia, they still have possession of the ball. Zings this pass, has it complete to Damian Gary. Gain of 9 on the play.
Corey Phillips again, just staying very calm, cool, and collected. They're working on Rodney Creighton in the short side of the field.
By the way, we saw Bennett there, 30-43, his longest field goal as that ball is tipped in, almost intercepted by Larry Kasher.
Larry Kasher in good shape to knock that ball away and almost pick it off. Here again, you look for players who make plays all season. Auburn surely will bracket Terrence Edwards, number 8, with 2 defenders.
Kasher tonight, 8 tackles, 7 of them solo, and also 2 pass breakups. Second down and 10. Phillips has it complete to Gary. He is inside the 10-yard line. Rodney Creighton with the cover, but it's good for 19 yards.
Yeah, no pressure at all on Corey Phillips the last couple plays. Been able to sit in the pocket and find Damian Gary on this route. You see a good job of the offensive line protecting. Damian Gary gets Rodney Creighton turned around.
Well, I can tell you right now, Jim Donnan, as we look at Bennett on the sideline, this is definitely 4-down territory, and he does not want a field goal. He doesn't want to tie this thing. He wants to get it in the end zone and head back to Athens.
Here's where they have a problem again, O'Ron, when you get inside the 10-yard line without a running game. They ran a draw on first down the last series. See if they go back to the draw with Brett Milliken.
Gary, 6 catches. That's a career high for him. Off the mark, looking for Gary again, and I'll tell you, they keep going back to Creighton's side.
But you can play a lot tighter now with the ball inside the 10-yard line in coverage. Jim Donnan actually giving the play to Corey Phillips, who ran off the sideline to get this play.
So they break the huddle with a 2nd down and goal. You can see where the ball is located. Phillips, middle screen. That's Damian Gary, and he hung a cleat in the turf or something and fell down. He was going down before contact was made.
Georgia's going to take a timeout, Ron. It would lead them with 1 timeout.
So let's take a break. 53 seconds left in our ball game. It is 23-20 Auburn.
Would $1,000 in your checking account today bring you relief tomorrow? Hi, I'm Warren Moon, a proud member of the Pro Money Source team. Click or call us, and within 24 hours, we can get you up to $1,000 deposited directly into your bank account. Think of it. Rent, paid. Childcare costs, paid. Household expenses, paid. Pro Money Source connects you to hundreds of lenders. Click or call now and get cash in your bank account today.
Heisman hopeful Andrew Luck and the unbeaten Cardinal host division rival Oregon in a high-stakes top 10 showdown with Pac-12 and national championship implications. Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines. Oregon, Stanford, Saturday at 8 on ABC. College football lives here.
Introducing the official training bike of the Tour de France, the ProForm TDF, the first ever indoor training bike that delivers everything you demand. A 20% incline and a 20% decline, so you'll experience exactly what the road does. Because it's powered by Google Maps, you choose the road and the TDF follows it. Every incline and decline, so no matter what comes at you, you'll be ready. The ProForm TDF automatically adjusts resistance, incline and decline. Plus, with a built-in power meter, you'll know your exact output. You decide where to go, and the official training bike of the Tour takes you there. And now that you've decided, we're ready to deliver. Order right now and get zero down and a free upgrade on rush shipping. Call the number on your screen or go.
On the spot, call the play. Where would you try to find the hole in the Tiger defense?
I'm going to try to find it to the wide side of the field. I'm going to put Terrence Edwards over there somewhere where I can get him on a route. But I'm sure Jim Donnan told Corey Phillips, we do not need an interception here either. We could tie with a field goal, but we'd like to win this right now. But Edwards would be the guy I would look for. He's a middle receiver right here.
Third down and goal. They're going to run it. Takes off to the left.
Edwards, did he get it?
Real close run. Good call by Jim Donnan.
Well, you remember we talked about that they would be able to pick up a first down without scoring, but where they had placed it down. This is certainly not close enough.
And Terrence Edwards on a sweep all the way. Jim Donnan lines him up at quarterback. He's going to take the field goal here. He's close. He's in.
That Watts. He stays in right there. It's the left
out.
Foot. Otherwise, he scores it. I mean, the official's right there.
Yeah.
Billy Bennett with the field goal attempt. 19 yards. And he got it. 41 seconds left in our ball game, and we are tied at 23. You know, Mike, the interesting thing is Edwards was literally 6 inches from scoring as far as being able to keep that foot in bounds.
I think what Jim Donnan's arguing about, but he was out of bounds.
Oh, yeah, there's no question. But you just look how very close that his momentum took him just that much to the sideline. See, he's in bounds there. He's out of bounds right there at the 1.5.
Before he stretches the football out.
Yeah. So it all comes down to two young men from Hartwell, Georgia.
And number 8, Edwards. As they stick him at quarterback in a key situation, Ron.
Now, when you look at strategy for something like this, this is one of those things where the fans want you to go for all the marbles. If you're Tommy Tuberville, unless you get a long kick return, don't you burn the 41 seconds
well,
on the clock?
You run a draw or you hit a screen and see what you pick up. To pick up some good yardage, then you keep it in play. Because he still has 3 timeouts. Kickoff is what's going to dictate his strategy, what kind of return he gets.
First half belonged to Georgia. Then a goodly part of the second half belonged to Auburn until a blocked kick. The momentum shifted, and now it is the Georgia Bulldogs who have come back and tied this ball game at 23. Kerouac with the kick. 1 yard deep in the end zone. This is Hood.
Now, Ron, a draw or some type of quick screen. See if you can pick up anything. Otherwise, we're heading for overtime.
The numbers on Ben Lear tonight, 22 of 36, 146 yards, two touchdowns and two interceptions. One of those intercepts with 75 yards for a touchdown. And Duvall, well, we have talked about his effectiveness and how good he has been. Auburn calls a timeout.
Took too long to get the ball, to get the players on the field, and they took too long.
Goes without saying, nobody has left this stadium tonight.
Damon Duvall, Ron, has been big tonight for Auburn in the kicking game. You can see the distance he gets on his field goals. Right down Main Street.
That thing there might have gone 60-something yards.
There's Eddie Grant, who's responsible for the kicking game.
Well, 1996, yes, 1996, it took four overtimes for Georgia to win the football game. Are we headed to overtime tonight? Both coaches pacing on the sideline. Rudy Johnson back into the short side of the field. Millard will knock him down.
Yes, a safe play, Ron. Again, you're backed up. You don't want to make a mistake here. Looks like that both teams will be satisfied to go to overtime. See what happens on this play. 31 seconds left. Still two timeouts for Auburn. They could hit a play, get a run, get Rudy loose. It looks like it's going to be Rudy time here. Try to make a play.
Rudy Johnson again, this time right up the middle, and he was within a step. You could see very quickly Jermaine Phillips was coming up. It was not the last man that he was about to beat in Tony Gilbert. But he gets into that hole very rapidly. Kids on the bench looking up at the clock. Jonas Jennings here says, okay, let's go to a little overtime. 11 seconds, now 10, and that's exactly what's going to happen. We're going to have an extra period as Georgia and Auburn are going to finish 60 minutes of play, tied at 23. Overtime records, Georgia 2-1, Auburn 0-1.
And Jim Donnan, who coached at Marshall, won AA for many years, used the overtime quite a bit more in 1AA than he has in 1.
So we'll talk more about it. Timeout on the field. We are through regulation and headed to overtime, tied at 23.
21st Century Insurance here with proof that many of you are paying too much for your car insurance. These two cars have the same coverage, one through Allstate, the other through 21st Century. Both cars are covered, so both cars get the same repairs. Here's the difference, though. Drivers who switch from Allstate to 21st save an average of $516 a year for the same coverage. Aha, you say, but what if I don't have Allstate? Well, that's okay, because drivers who switch from Progressive to 21st save even more. Call 21st Century right now if you're near a phone, and really, who isn't these days? At 888-GET-2121, that's 888-GET-2121, or visit 21st.com. 21st Century Auto Insurance, the same great coverage for less.
Celebrate another St. Louis Cardinals World Series title with Sports Illustrated's exclusive championship package. you'll get this must-have official 2011 World Series DVD. Plus this limited edition hardcover book. Relive the Cardinals' postseason heroics with MLB Productions' amazing video and SI's famous writing and photography. Go to SIOffer.com or call now to get both free with a paid subscription. 56 issues for only $1.59 an issue. Save 65% off the cover price. Use your credit or debit card and get this officially licensed championship baseball honoring the St. Louis Cardinals. Designed exclusively for SI, it features the World Series and team logos, plus a special display cue. Don't miss this terrific offer. Go to SIOffer.com or call now to get the official DVD, the commemorative book, and the collectible baseball. This incredible package is all free and only available from Sports Illustrated. Call or go online now.
Two elite teams battle aboard the USS Carl Vinson. Michigan State versus preseason number one North Carolina. The Quicken Loans Carrier Classic, Friday at 7 on ESPN.
Each team gets one possession from the opponent's 25 per overtime until the winner is decided. No game clock, play clock only. And teams must go for two-point conversion after the second overtime. That's almost like the Georgia-Auburn rule after they had that marathon.
Ron, I don't like this overtime rule, and I'll tell you why. Because we've seen kicking game determine this ball game tonight. You take the punters out of the football game. You take the kickoff men out of the football game. I don't like it.
SportsCenter coming up next. Corey Phillips comes trotting out. Remember, no game clock, but there is a play clock, and it is already at 8 and counting. From the shotgun, right up the middle, and that is Milliken, who was out for the coin flip. And Auburn has a player down at the line of scrimmage. That looks like Alex Lincoln, the middle linebacker, who is shaken up on the play.
Been a well-played football game, well-officiated game. It's the best crew I've seen officiating this year.
Do not disagree.
No, it's been quick, decisions quick. They've been on top of everything, and been a well-played football game.
Now, Lincoln, you could see him moving his legs. Maybe we can get a better idea of what happened here. Then he got kicked in the head by his teammate. That's 52 Mark Brown, who accidentally kicked Lincoln in the head. Lincoln's got three tackles tonight, all solo, one for a loss.
And a big story, Ron, because he wasn't recruited out of high school, went to Mississippi College, played football, transferred here, was the leading tackler last year on this football team. Leading tackler this year on the team.
If you just now tuned in, the reason that we were taking a shot of number two Tim Carter on the sideline, he suffered a blow to the head back in regulation and had to be taken to the hospital by ambulance. But they got him there, checked him over, and realized that that he had taken a severe lick. It went without saying, but that he was okay. Nothing super severe. Sports Center coming up next. We're tied at 23. We're in overtime. That was the first play that has been run in overtime. There are flags down everywhere. Milliken looked like McNeil came across and may have made contact, although Auburn is pointing at Georgia.
Head ball, contact by the defense. 5-yard penalty will be a first
down. And on overtime, you don't need to do anybody any favors when you're starting the scrimmage line at the 25.
Everybody points, though, right away. If you make a mistake, point.
Alex Lincoln being checked over by the team physician on the sideline. Auburn 23, Georgia 23. First overtime. They run it back into the boundary. Milliken spins around. He's going to have a gain of close to five. He's down to the 10.
Ron, now the strategy for Jim Donnan looks to be changing a little bit now. He doesn't want to put the pressure on Corey Phillips here. He's more run game oriented now. Remember the problems Georgia has had in this ballgame when they get inside the 10-yard line. They have had problems throwing the football, and they've had to settle for some field goals. But here they're running the ball better with Milliken.
Milliken hit by Mark Brown and stopped just after he spun inside the 10. Mark Brown's had a nice game tonight. We have called his name quite a few times. In fact, we have him officially at six tackles on the evening.
Inside the 20, the 19, the problems they've had getting touchdowns.
Third down and four. Here comes the pressure. Lobs for the end zone. There's nobody there. It's going to be fourth down for the Georgia Bulldogs.
Going to take the field goal. And this, when they go back and look at the tape tomorrow, the inability, once they get inside the 15-yard line, to knock it in the end zone could be the difference in this ballgame.
Bennett from 25 yards. Good pass, and he knocks it home right down the middle. So Georgia is on the board in the overtime period, and now it's Auburn's turn. And according to the rules, and I'm sure you have followed football and this setup long enough to know, that Auburn has to answer at least with a field goal to keep this overtime going. If they score a touchdown, it is Auburn's game that they have won. So here comes the Auburn offense. Ball put down at the 25-yard line. We are in overtime. Georgia now on top, 26-23. No turnovers here, because if the defense takes it away, game over if you have the advantage. Ball is tipped. It is caught by Green, and what a dangerous situation right there. This overtime almost ended on that play.
Josh Millard really almost came up with a game-saving play, tipped the ball, almost got back over, but then hustled over and made the tackle. Number 98 going to get his big right paw on this football, and now he hustles over and makes the play on Marcel Willis. A little surprised they didn't open up with Rudy Johnson.
Because it's a second down and 12 from here. Here comes Rudy right at the middle. Has 5, 7, 8. Counted off at 9 yards. And Witherspoon made the tackle.
Well, you have him second and 12. And then Rudy just rattled off about 10 of those 12. And you can expect Rudy again. I think everybody in this crowd feels that Rudy's going to get this football.
They've already started the Rudy. Third down and two. Here's the pitch. Johnson, blocker in front. Oh, what a block by 44 Heath Evans to clear the way, and they have the first down.
One thing this gives you, Ron, you point out the fullback, Heath Evans. Hellman went back.
That was Tony Gilbert that he rocked him back. Here we come right here. Bam.
You do have the opportunity to fake the Rudy, and you may get a game-winning pass here of Ben Laird, but I'm not sure I'd take it out of Rudy's hands.
First down, Tigers. Ball just inside the 15-yard line. Georgia scored on the first possession of overtime. It's now Auburn's turn. Quick pass. It is caught. That's Willis inside the 10-yard line at the 8.
What happens when Rudy runs the ball? You got to try to get that 8th guy in the box to stop the running game. And that opens it up. You get one-on-one coverage on the outside.
Now here's the tough decision, I would think. You run Rudy again or do you throw him?
I run Rudy. Rudy, Rudy, and Rudy. And more Rudy.
From the 8, they run it back into the short side of the field. Breaks a tackle. And is knocked down at the 1-foot line. Auburn, 1 foot away from closing out the overtime. Jermaine Phillips finally knocked him out.
Ben Laird came over the sideline and told Tommy Tucker, only thing I can think of, he's telling me he could quarterback sneak it for the touchdown. And that's what a big back's supposed to do, Ron. Wear people down in the fourth quarter, and if there's an overtime, wear them down more there. They brought the corner off the short side of the field. Just too tough, to bring down. Good tackle by Jermaine Phillips to keep him from getting in that end zone.
So the situation, first down and goal, and that ball is inside the 1 yard line. Georgia scored a field goal on their first offensive possession in overtime, but now the Tigers, as Georgia calls a timeout, they are about 6 inches away. Well, the voting is complete. Tonight's Visa Player of the Game is selected by you, the fans at home on ESPN.com, is Rudy Johnson. 145 rushing yards, received almost 45% of the votes on ESPN.com.
Can almost guarantee it's going to be a quarterback sneak here. They quarterback sneaked early in the ball game for a key first down. Ben Laird, 6'4", 222. Take the ball off the line of scrimmage. I'm going to give the quarterback one chance to see if he can get it in.
Talk about a game of momentum swings. Tommy Tuberville's team in the first half, they were about as flat as you can be, with the exception of just before halftime, as Lincoln receives treatment with ice in the back of his neck. They got the field goal to go in at halftime, 13-3, and then they scored on their next three possessions. Then Georgia came back. Corey Phillips can't look, and I don't blame him. The young man has done a nice job tonight under extreme duress.
It's tough when you lose your number one quarterback. But Ben Laird will tell this offensive line is clear it out.
There's a lot of celebrating on the field, but thank goodness cooler heads prevailed as far as people storming the field, and these goalposts will stay intact.
It's a big win for Auburn, Ron. Big win keeps them alive in the West, and then they get to face Alabama coming off a high.
And you have to admit, like, the way they looked in the first half, there's no way that they would win this football game.
No,
they were as flat as any team I've ever seen.
But they stayed in the game, and they came on the second half, got a big kickoff return right off the bat, and Rudy Johnson took over. Tommy Tuberville couldn't even look. Nobody looked.
Corey Phillips, obviously. Very, very disappointed. Down at Toomer's Corner. Well, part of the tradition as they throw the toilet paper into the tree across from the drugstore. Final score, Auburn in overtime, 29 and Georgia 26. Coming up next is SportsCenter. Next Saturday night, we'll be up at the Carrier Dome as number two-ranked Miami takes on Syracuse. From Mike Godfrey to Adrian Karsten and our entire ESPN crew, I'm Ron Franklin. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com, your home for college football on the Internet. Ron Franklin saying so long, everybody, from the plains of Alabama.